Hey, turn them loose. Ah, you bronze, fatten up. Got him?
They're honking their horn.
Maybe they lost. Come on.
Hi there. Thanks for stopping. You live around here?
Sure do. Broken Wheel Ranch, just over yonder.
Actually, I'm looking for a man named Harrington. Do you know him?
You mean Old Man Harrington? Well, he ain't been around here for years. His place is up there.
No, I don't mean the old man. He's dead. I mean his nephew, Alec.
The old man's dead?
Oh, he's been dead for more than a year. Have you ever met his nephew?
Nope. Never even heard of him. Is he around here?
Well, they told us we could find him at his cabin. Could you tell us how to get there?
Sure. Just turn at the end of the fence there and keep on going.
Well, it's not as simple as that. You see, my partner and I here are thinking of buying...
Easy, Pat. We don't know this man.
Oh, he looks all right to me. Don't be so jumpy.
We made our plans. Let's stick to him.
Why, you're offending the gentleman. You talk as if you didn't trust him.
That has nothing to do with it. We just can't broadcast what we're going to do.
You'll have to excuse my partner. You know, we've got a pretty big deal going here, and he's a little nervous. Oh, by the way, my name is Smith. This is my partner, Jack Jordan.
Pete Wilkie. This here's Joey Newton, our rancher just beyond.
Ah, glad to know you, Mr. Wilkie. How are you, Joey?
Fine, thank you.
No offense, Mr. Wilkie.
It's a fine horse you got there, Joey.
Thank you. His name's Fury.
Yeah, finest piece of horse flesh in the country.
I can see you know horses, Mr. Wilkie. Seems to me he has a bit of thoroughbred in him.
It takes a man that knows horses to see that.
Pat, I've been completely wrong about Mr. Wilkie. Never knew a man who liked horses that wasn't okay. Why couldn't Mr. Wilkie do this job for us?
Wait a minute, Jack. Not so fast. We can't just pick anyone to...
I'm sure Mr. Wilkie can get along with Harrington.
Well, maybe Mr. Wilkie hasn't got time.
Have you any objections to making a few $100, Mr. Wilkie?
Doing what?
Well, we'd like to buy a few acres of Harrington's property, but he won't deal with us. He calls us city slickers.
We'd like you to make the offer for us. If he accepts it, fine. If he doesn't, well, nobody's hurt.
What do you figure Harrington's land is worth an acre, Mr. Wilkie?
What part of his land?
Right here.
And ain't nothing much up there except rocks. Maybe $40.
Well, that's what we figure. Now, we've got a check here for $4,000. Made out to Mr. Harrington. We'd like 100 acres. Right in here.
Well, supposing he won't sell.
We'll pay you $200 for your troubles.
Well, it seems like a lot of money for a small favor, but I'm glad to oblige you.
Good. Here's your $200. And if he accepts the offer, we'll give you 200 more. What do you say?
Okay. Now, where do I meet you?
Right here, day after tomorrow at noon.
I'll see Harrington first thing in the morning.
Harrington's a little touchy about strangers. Now, you be careful.
Don't worry, I can handle him. Come on, Joey. What did that mean?
Remember Mr. Jordan said Mr. Harrington didn't like strangers?
Yeah, but he don't have to shoot that close just to warn us. There he is.
Next time I won't miss. Get off my property.
Sure is a mean cuss, ain't he? Mr. Harrington! Take it easy! We're friends!
What do you want?
We're on business!
Well, why'd you say so? Come on up!
Now stay behind me, Joey. Just in case he changes his mind. Well, you know, you gotta be careful up here. There's no telling who's sneaking around these days. A man's land ain't his own no more. Now, what can I do for you, Pete? Well, like I says, I come to make an offer to you on a piece of your property. And this section, right here. It ain't nothing but rocks. Well, that stuff ain't even good for snakes. Man like you needs land that'll grow something. This ain't for me. I'm making the offer for a couple other fellas. Yeah? What are they offering? 4,000 for 100 acres. 4,000 for them rocks? That's right. Wonder what they want with it. You getting anything out of this? $200 for making the offer and $400 if you take it. Yeah. You know something, Pete? I ain't taking it.
That's a lot of money for them rocks.
Yeah. Well, I think them fellas know something. If that's worth $4,000 to them, it's worth $4,000 to me. Yeah, you wait here a minute.
Gosh.
I ain't licked yet. Hey, Ian. You know anything about these things?
Sure, it's a Geiger counter. I worked one once.
Yeah? Well, this one's Plum Loco. Ticks like mad. Right down where those fellas want to buy.
Ticks? Well, that means only one thing, uranium.
So that's why they want that land.
Hey, trying to slick me, huh?
Gosh, Mr. Harrington, if you've got uranium on your land, you're rich.
Yeah, but what do I know about mining uranium?
If it's there, the government will help you.
All I know is that thing goes Plum Loco every time I go down there with it.
Well, come on, let's take a look at it.
I hope you know what you're doing, Pete.
If this here thing ticks like you say it does, you got uranium.
Well, let's go. Well, here it is. The whole wall around here is jumping. Go ahead, try it. Shivering wildcats. Look, George.
Gosh, she really is jumping.
You mean that thing ain't loco like I thought?
This thing ticking the way it does means that you're worth a fortune. You're rich.
Now, don't pull my leg, Pete. I ain't that dumb.
I mean it, Alec. To begin with, you'll get $35,000 from the government just for discovering it.
$35,000?
Of course, you'll have to prove out. You'll have to mine it and see what your assays.
Is it gonna cost me?
Might.
Well, I ain't got much cash, Pete. Maybe $4,000, all I got in the world. But if you want to match it and be my partner, we'll split 50-50.
You mean you'll sell me a half interest in all this for $4,000?
Well, I don't know nothing about this stuff. Never even seen a mine. I gotta have a fella like you that knows all about it and ain't a city slicker someone I can trust.
Well, maybe I will be able to raise $4,000.
It's a deal. But you'll have to handle the whole thing, Pete. You'll have to boss the whole job and handle all the money, too.
Don't you worry, Alec. I can handle this thing left-handed.
Now you're talking, partner. Let's go up to the cabin and talk it all over.
Right. Well, then I guess we're set, Pete. When will I see you?
I'm going right into the bank now in town, get the money, and get back here this afternoon. Reckon we need a paper between us?
No, I don't. Your word's good enough for me. Ain't much of a man who'll shake on a deal and then break his word.
Well, that's the way I feel about it. And here's my hand on it, partner. Come on, Joey, we got a lot of traveling to do.
Yeah. See you later, Mr. Harrington.
Yeah, goodbye, Joey. Goodbye. So long, Joey. So long, Pete.
You missed your calling. You should have been an actor.
Well, I'm telling you, partners, you don't often find a man like Pete. Where did you find a sucker like this? He's the greatest.
He brings that money back this afternoon. We're leaving town tonight.
Wait a minute. What about his boss, Jim?
No use being greedy about it. They can't hang a thing on us with this deal. No paper. It's your word against his. We're clean. And $4,000 to the good.
The way they talk about Jim, he's a bigger sucker than Pete. Honest as the day is long.
Yeah, there's no sense passing up easy money. Well, okay, we'll give Jim one play. If it works, fine. If not, we're long gone.
All right, you two, let's have it. Why are you both so pleased with yourselves?
Okay, Joey, tell him.
They're all gonna be rich. Pete owns a half interest in the uranium mine.
Is this on the level?
Sure thing. A half interest in a mine that looks like a real strike. It's got a Geiger counter chirping like a cricket.
Where is it?
Up by the Harrington Ranch.
The Harrington Ranch? There's uranium up there?
There sure is, Jim.
Did you buy this half interest?
Sure did, and I'm going to run the whole show.
What did it cost you?
Only $4,000.
$4,000?
You paid $4,000 for a half interest in a uranium mine on the Harrington Ranch?
A bargain, huh, Jim? A real bargain.
Who sold it to you?
Alec Harrington.
Well, Alec Harrington's in Europe. He has been for years.
Well, the old man is dead. This is his nephew.
Well, unless I'm completely misinformed, there isn't any uranium within 200 miles of the Harrington Ranch.
But we heard the Geiger counter tick.
Ellen, will you find out if Mr. Brownell of the bank is at home? $4,000 because you heard something tick. Oh, hello, Bob. This is Jim Newton. Yes, I'm fine, thanks. How are you? Bob, do you know where Alec Harrington is? You're sure about that? Is any of his land for sale? Uh-huh. All right, now one last question. Does he have a nephew? I see. Uh-huh. All right, thanks, Bob. Goodbye.
What'd he say?
He said Alec Harrington's in Europe. He's alive.
Alive?
Alive and kicking, and the bank says that there isn't any part of his land for sale at any price. And he hasn't got a nephew.
Why, that means...
Yeah, I'm afraid that's what it means, Pete. I'm afraid you can kiss your $4,000 goodbye.
Last dime I had. I'm calling the sheriff. They can't get away with this.
Oh, hang on. Throwing them in jail won't get your money back for you.
Why not? They stole it from me. The sheriff will make them give it back.
Can you prove they stole it? They didn't give you a bill of sale or anything in writing?
No, just a handshake.
How'd you pay them?
Cold, hard, gone cash.
I'm sorry, Pete. I know just how you feel. This isn't any time to be stewing about it. We've got to think. Let's see, they didn't take it from you forcibly, so we can't get it back forcibly. We've got to figure out a way to make them hand that money back to you and then throw them in jail.
Hand it back to me? Fat chance.
Joey, can you remember anything that Pete hasn't mentioned?
Only that Mr. Harrington didn't mind if we told you about it, but we couldn't tell anybody else.
Yeah, that's right. They said it was okay if we let you in on it.
Oh, so that's it, huh? They figure I'm a sucker, too. Well, that's just what I'm gonna be.
Get around behind that bush, Fury. If we're gonna be undercover agents, we've gotta keep hidden and keep watch. Just like Jim said. We don't want them slipping out on us. And if they see us, it can ruin all of Jim's plans. Understand? What a mess. All the money poor Pete worked so hard to get. Guess he's not up yet.
Now, let me get this straight. If they don't actually hand the money back to Pete, the only way he can get it is to sue. Uh-huh. And now, one more thing. I'm gonna need $4,000 for about 24 hours. Can you let me have it? All right, thanks, Ed. Fine, I'll pick it up about noon. Bye.
Oh, the more I think how they hornswoggled me, the madder I get. How can I be so dumb?
Well, you're not the first person who's fallen for this game, Pete. But getting mad about it won't help. If you really want your $4,000 back, you've got to keep your wits about you. Now, let's go over what the lawyer said.
What's the matter, Fury? They are. What do you suppose they're doing that for? We better tell Jim.
What is it, Joey?
I just saw Mr. Smith and Mr. Jordan up at the cabin. And guess what they were doing? They were shooting away at rocks with the shotgun.
Yeah, looks like they're getting ready for me.
But they said they didn't know Mr. Harrington.
They said a lot of things they're going to regret. All right, now, Pete, it's your turn. We've got two things to remember. First, sell them on the idea that I want in on the deal, and then make them draw up a contract. The sheriff is going to want written evidence against them.
Okay, but I sure would like to take a poke at them.
How do men get to be such crooks, Jim?
Oh, greed, Joey. That's why they just can't pass up the chance to steal my money, too. Incidentally, you did a good job.
You mean Fury did?
What did Fury do this time?
Well, I fell asleep. I guess Fury saw him across the canyon. Kept nudging me till I woke up.
Well, if we get Pete's money back, we'll buy him a whole bushel full of carrots.
Hey!
Howdy.
Oh, Mr. Wilkie. How'd you make out with Harrington?
I'm sorry, but he wouldn't take it.
He's very foolish turning down $4,000 for those rocks.
Well, he figures if it's worth four to you, it's worth four to him. But I sure got to thank you men for letting me in on something real good.
What do you mean by that?
First off, I want to give you back the $200 you gave me. Thank you. You see, Harrington found a uranium vein up there, and I bought in on it.
Uranium?
That's right. Had his Geiger counter really spitting. Even my boss, Jim Newton, is interested.
Well, why can't we get in on this? You know, this isn't fair. We steered you into the whole deal.
That's right, you did. I'll tell you what, ain't no harm in asking. Now, Harrington turned out to be a pretty nice fella. Real friendly.
Can you arrange for us to meet him?
Sure. Just take your car right up to his place. I'll take the shortcut over the hill, and I'll meet you in front of the house.
We certainly appreciate this, Mr. Wilkie. We had a hunch there might be something in them rocks.
Well, if it's as good as it looks, there's plenty for all of us. See you. Two men I made the offer for. Mr. Smith, Mr. Jordan, I want you to meet Mr. Harrington.
How do you do, sir?
Howdy.
I thought we were going to keep this a secret.
If it wasn't for these two men, you and me wouldn't be partners.
But we're only trying to help you, Mr. Harrington. If your land is as good as Mr. Wilkie here says it is, you'll need money to work it properly.
Well, maybe we won't need your money. Did you speak to Jim?
Sure did.
Well, and we got plenty. How much can he put in?
Same as me, $4,000.
Well, that's $12,000. I don't think we'll use more than that.
Just a minute, Mr. Harrington. Suppose my partner and I put up $6,000 for a half interest right now. Cash, you understand. What's more, we'll supply all the money needed to work the property successfully. And none of you will have to put up a dime more than your original investment.
Are you ready to put up ready cash with that offer?
Here's $2,000 now. If you sign the contract, you get $4,000 more. If not, we take it back.
How does that sound to you, partner?
Sounds great to me.
Well, look. Why must we let Jim in on it? Why can't you and me split up the profits ourselves?
But I promised him. He's in town getting the money right now.
Well, I guess you can't break your word.
Supposing we all meet at your ranch this afternoon and get this whole thing settled, huh?
Well, suits me. I'll get right back and tell Jim. Oh, Alec, you better get all this down on paper. I'm a little mixed up about what I own.
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Wilkie. We'll have it all spelled out.
Boy, will Jim be surprised to hear this. See you later.
Jim, partner! It's spelled out, Jim, just like they said.
I really appreciate you letting me in on this deal, Mr. Harrington.
Well, the way Pete talked, I knew he was just the kind of a man I like to do business with.
Well, it seems to be all here. Mr. Smith, I guess it's up to you now.
It's a pleasure, Mr. Newton. And I don't mind telling you, I consider this a real bargain day, Mr. Harrington.
Now, where do I sign
that? You better let me count Mr. Smith's money. We gotta be real businesslike about this deal.
Certainly glad I got a smart partner. I've never been thinking myself about counting it. Jim, sign right here.
Uh-huh. Well, now, does anybody here have a pen?
Oh, right here, Mr. Newton.
You know, this time clause gives you just 1 month to raise the money that you need to work the mine.
Seems to me that you ought to have 6 months at least.
Oh, don't worry about that, Mr. Newton. We'll raise the money within a week. Say, where's he going?
Hmm? Oh, he's going to the bank.
The bank? What for?
Put his money back.
His money? Why, that's Alex!
What's going on here?
I'll tell you what's going on here. You three hustlers fleeced Pete out of $4,000 and you just handed it back to him. It's all his. That's what the law says.
That's what you think. Keep out of it, Pete.
Gary! Gary! Go help him, Fury.
Go call the sheriff, will you, Joey?
Yes, sir. You stay here, Fury. Jim may need you.
Watch him, Fury. You've got two eyes, and right now I've only got one.
Well, did you bring us a couple of gold bricks?
Ah, lay off me, Jim. So I pulled a boner. Boy, who give you that?
You should have seen what he did to him. Took on all three.
Well, I had a little help from Fury.
You should have seen Jim and Fury. They were terrific. You sure missed something, Pete.
All right, is the money in the bank?
All but $100.
$100?
Yeah, I grubstaked the feller for $100. He's going to give me half of what he finds.
What's he looking for, uranium?
Gold.
Pete Wilkie, when are you going to quit chasing easy money?
What's easy money, Jim?
That's the kind of money you don't work for, Joey.
And just remember, there ain't no such thing. You gotta work for everything you get.
Don't be like Pete and have to learn the hard way. $4,000.
I sure got slicker, didn't I?